Hi everyone, in this problem we're going to use the second derivative test from calculus to find all relative extrema. So we're going to find the relative maximums and minimums of this function using what's called the second derivative test. Okay, so the first step in the second derivative test is to find the critical numbers. So we take the derivative and we set it equal to zero. So we're going to find critical numbers. Or multiple ones, possibly. So we'll take the derivative. So f prime of x is equal to... So this derivative is really easy. You just use the power rule. You bring down the 3, so you get 3x. And then you subtract 1, so you get 2. So 3x squared. And then here, 2 times 3 is 6. So minus 6x. And the derivative of 2 is 0, so I won't bother to write it. And we're looking for critical numbers. So critical numbers are numbers in the domain of the function where the derivative is undefined, which doesn't occur here. There's no fractions, there's no square roots, or where it's equal to zero. So we're going to set it equal to zero. Looks like we can factor out 3x here. So 3x parentheses, looks like we'll need an x, because x times x is x squared, and then a minus 2, right? 2 times 3x is 6x. We have a product equal to 0, so we set each factor equal to 0. So 3x equals 0, or x minus 2 is 0. So whenever you have a product equal to 0, it's got to be 0 here, you can do this. Here you divide by 3, so we'll get x equals 0. And then here we'll add 2, so we'll get x equals 2. And as a mental check, we should make sure we can plug these back into the function, and we can. Right, the domain of this function is all real numbers. There's no fractions. It's a polynomial. Everything is good. So I'm going to put these in boxes. These are our critical numbers. These are our CN, CNs. Okay, the second step is to plug the critical numbers into the second derivative. So 2. I'm going to write that down. So plug CNs into F double prime of x, so into the second derivative. The steps are really important in the second derivative test. That's why I'm writing them down. The most common source of confusion for people is they mix the steps up. They get confused between this and finding intervals where things are concave up and concave down. So it's really important to understand these steps. Okay, we have to take the derivative again. So f double prime of x. And again, this is a nice problem because the derivatives are easy. We're not bogged down by some messy calculus. 2 times 3 is 6x. And then the derivative of 6x is minus 6, so minus 6. And you might be wondering, oh, you set it equal to 0. No, right? We're going to plug the critical numbers into the second derivative. Let's plug in 0. So f double prime of 0. That's our first critical number. So 6 times 0 minus 6. That's negative 6. That's less than 0. So because it's negative, we have a max at x equals 0. So the way I do it is I just memorize it. I just memorize it as it's backwards. So if the second derivative is negative, you have a max. Positive, you have a min. So negative second derivative, max. Positive, you have a min. Another way to think about it is, the second derivative is negative. So it's concave down, so you probably have a max. That's more intuitive, but I just memorize it. So negative, you have a max. And to find your max, what you do is you take this number and you plug it back into your original. Okay. So f of 0, let's go ahead and finish it and find the max. 0 cubed minus 3, 0 squared, plus 2, that's equal to 2. So your maximum is actually 2. Okay, this is your max. The answer is 2. However, if you're doing like homework, oftentimes they want the ordered pair. So 0 comma 2, this is where your max is at, where it occurs. The max is at 0 comma 2. It's not really the max though, okay? The max is 2, so just keep that in mind. It's a subtle point. All right, so just recap, what did we just do? We took the critical number, we plugged it into the second derivative, which is right here. It was negative, so we have a max. And then to find the actual max, you take your critical number and you plug it back into your original function, which was up here, which was f of x. Now we do the same thing with 2, which is our other critical number. So f double prime of 2. Again, you plug it into the second derivative. So 6 times 2 minus 6. So 12 minus 6. So 6. So it's positive. So that means we have a min. Remember, it's backwards. Think of it as backwards. Min at x equals 2. So this is where our min occurs, right, at x equals 2. And as before, to actually find the minimum value of the function, you take this number and you plug it back into the original. Now, I can't see the original problem, so I'm going to rewrite it down here to make it easier for myself. X cubed minus 3x squared plus 2. So x cubed minus 3x squared plus 2. I don't have it written down anywhere. I'm just doing it for the first time. So we take it and go back to the original. So f of 2 is equal to 2 cubed minus 3 times 2 squared plus 2. This is going to be 8 minus 3 times 4 is 12 plus 2. Going fast, this is negative 4 plus 2. You can use a calculator for this, right? And there it is. There's your min. So the actual minimum is negative 2. However, if you're doing this for a class, most of the time they want the ordered pair. So the minimum is at the ordered pair 2 comma negative 2. So that's where the min occurs, and that's where the max occurs. This is a really good problem because it's simple, and so you can really focus on, like, do you know the steps? Let me go over it one more time. All right, you see the original question. The question says to use the second derivative to find all relative extrema. So step one is you just take that first derivative and set it equal to 0. Most of the time in these problems, it's not going to be undefined, but just be aware of it. If it is undefined, you also have to consider that. So, but it's not. You know, things are good. So, you know, set it equal to 0, solve. You get your critical numbers. Then you take these and you plug them into the second derivative. So we find our second derivative. In this case, it's super easy. And then here we start the process. Here we were checking 0. So here we check 0. That's what we did here first, right? We did 0 first. So that means you plug it into the second derivative. And what the second derivative does is it tells you if you have a max or a min. So if the second derivative is negative, you have a max. If it's positive, you have a min. Just try to think backwards. In this case, it was negative, so we have a max. And to actually find the maximum value, you go back to the original. Always go back to the original function. So we did that here, and we got 2. So 2 is the actual maximum. Just keep that in mind as like a good like life knowledge thing. The maximum is just this number. However, most homework systems, they do want the ordered pair, which is just 0, 2. This is not the maximum, by the way. This is just where it occurs. Then you were going to check 2. This is what we were doing here. So check 2. Again, the second derivative just tells us whether it's going to be a max or a min. So this negative 6, we don't use it for anything except like an indicator. It just tells us what's going to happen. So here we plugged in 2 into the second derivative. It was positive, so that tells us that we have a min. So we have a min at 2 to find the min as before. We go back to the original function. We plug in our 2 for all the x's. In this case, we got negative 2. Negative 2 is the min, but again, most homework systems want the ordered pair, so 2 comma negative 2. I hope this video has been helpful to someone out there who is trying to learn calculus. And remember, the second derivative, it's all about the steps. If you can follow these steps, you got this. Good luck.